Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure the Syncfusion Angular ListView component using the Angular CLI tool and Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Lists package. The Angular ListView component is a list-like interface that allows you to select an item or multiple items. I will also show you how to configure a few of this component's basic features, like binding data, grouping list items, adding checkboxes to a list, and adding nested list items. Let's start with the application creation process. First, I'll create my application using an Angular CLI command. I use VS Code as the editor and show the output in the Chrome browser. In the command prompt, I install the CLI tool globally using the npm install global Angular CLI command. Then I create a new Angular project using the ng new command and provide the app name, my Angular project. I navigate to the desired location and install the ListView package using the ng add syncfusion ej2 angular lists command. Now, I open the project in VS Code. I navigate to the app module page and import the ListView module from the syncfusion ej2 angular lists package. I register it in the imports array of the ng module. After that, I import the material theme styles to the style.css file to apply styles to the ListView component. Next, I need to register the Syncfusion license key. I open the main TypeScript file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the Angular trial license. Starting with the 2022 Volume 1 release, a license key is mandatory for Angular projects to avoid a licensing warning. In the app.component.html file, I replace the default code snippets with the Angular ListView component using the EJS ListView tag. Add styles to the container element. Let me run this application. See, the ListView is rendered with no records. Data can be bound to the list view using the data source property. I can bind an array of simple data, an array of JSON objects, and remote data. First, I'll show you binding to arrays of simple data. In the app component class, I declare a variable, list data, and assign the array of string values like artwork, modern painting, etc. I also need to map the ID and text fields while binding the data. For an array of simple data, both ID and text fields will be considered the same. Field mapping is not required. In the app component.html page, I assign that list data to the data source property of the ListView component. See here, the ListView displays the string array values. I can also bind a JSON array to the ListView component. In the data.ts file, I have already defined the group data object with fields, text, ID, and category. In the app component class, I import the group data from the data.ts file. I declare the variable carList and assign this JSON object. Then assign this object to the data source property. Now I need to map the JSON object fields to the ID and text fields using the fields property. In the app component class, I declare another variable, field settings. Here, I map the ID field from the group data object to the ID property and the text field to the text property. Text field values act as a display text. Here, both data source and field settings have fields with same name. So, field mapping is not required here. But to demonstrate the basic field mapping in the JSON array binding, I have mapped. Assign this field settings to the fields property. See here, the list view is rendered based on the JSON object. To bind remote data, I use the Syncfusion Data Manager. In the App Component class, I import the Data Manager from the namespace EJ2 data. Then, I declare the variable remote data and create an instance of the data manager to provide the service endpoint URL using the URL property. I assign the remote data link. Let's have a look at the remote data. It has fields like employee ID, first name, and so on. In the field settings, map the employee ID to the ID property and the first name field to the text property. To make the server understand the request and process the response, we need to specify the adapter type. You can refer to the different adapter types in the UG link provided in the description below. Here I use the Web API adapter and enable the cross-domain option. I assign this remote data variable to the datasource property. In the app component class, I declare another variable, dataQuery, and create a query instance to specify the field name to fetch from the remote data. Assign this variable to the query property in ListView. Checking now, the ListView shows remote data. Next, I will show you how to render a checklist. Checkboxes can be displayed by enabling the Show Checkbox property. See, the list view is rendered with a checkbox in each list item, and I can select multiple items. By default, the checkbox is positioned to the left of the list item text. You can change its position using the checkbox position property and setting its value to right. See now, the checkbox is positioned on the right. Next, I'll show you how to categorize the list view items using the group by property. Here I'm going to group the remote data based on the field designation. In the field settings, I add the group by property and set its value to designation. Look at the list view now. List items are categorized based on the designation. Finally, I will show you how to render a nested list. I have already defined the nested list data in the data.ts file. Each list contains fields like ID, text, and so on. Also, child list with same fields added to each parent lists. In the app component class, I import that data and assign it to the variable nested data and map the ID and text fields in the field settings. Then I remove the group by property and map the child field from the data source to the child property of field settings. Assign this nested data to the data source property. I can also show the list header by enabling the show header property and set the header title to folders. You can render the nested data with checkbox. In my example, I don't need it. Check now, nested list items are rendered. You can navigate to the sublist items by clicking any item and navigate back to the parent list item using the back icon at the top left. In this video, I showed you how to create and configure the Syncfusion Angular ListView component using the Angular CLI tool and Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Lists package, and I demonstrated a few of its basic features. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.